To finish talking about digitalization, now we have next Alina Joana Ivan Enescu, internationalization coordinator from Armeria School. Your project is called Virtual Reality in Teaching, VirTrain. Could you explain shortly that what the aim of VirTrain is?
Yes, first I'd like to mention that VirTrain stands for virtual reality for training or teaching, as you mentioned, but it focuses specifically on the sub-area of language teaching and language learning. Our project is supported by a consortium which brings together four different partners. The Association of Higher Education, Higher Professional Education from the Czech Republic, which is also the coordinator, the MTI Center from the Czech Republic as well, expert in language teaching, the Education Assessment Policy from the Italian Autonomous Region of Trento, and Armeria Scola, the vet provider from the Basque Country, which will directly test the results of the project with the students. And to answer your question, the aim of the project is to develop skills for teaching foreign languages through virtual reality in vocational education and training. So what we aspire to do is to show the benefits of virtual reality to the full extent, map the training needs, actually train the teachers, develop their teaching skills, and help them overcome potential barriers to the use of the virtual reality for teaching and learning.
What are the specific project activities and outputs?
Yes, so there are five different outputs and lots of activities. In the first stage of the project, we delved into the state of art about the usability of VR for language learning. Output 2 focuses on the development of an original methodology for VR courses. Output 3 will be a purpose-built course for teachers, which will have two dimensions. There will be an online course in Moodle available shortly before this summer, and there will also be a face-to-face course for 15 teachers from the three countries next September. After that, teachers will make their own lessons in VR. They will test them with the students. And we will put together a database for VR lessons. And last but not least, we will devise a final methodology on how to teach professional language skills through virtual reality in the vet sector. And I'd like to say that all the material of the project will be available, will be made available on a multilingual digital platform, which anyone interested will be able to check at the following address, www.virtrain.eu.
How will vet students benefit from the project?
Yeah, so virtual reality will help students become more engaged, and not only that, but also more concentrated in their learning process. It will help make lessons more lively. And so we are convinced that by making available the use of virtual reality to a wide professional audience, will eventually enhance the quality of teaching and learning in the vet sector.
Thank you very much, Alina,
for
being here with us.